Hello, my name is Alden, and welcome back to Riverdale Season 1, Episode 9. With me is Arif, my really good friend, and his friend XS. So this is Arif's place again, and I hope to do this more often. Arif, have you watched Riverdale?
No. I have no idea what.
Okay, so Riverdale is basically, you know, those like teen dramas. It's not a basic teen drama. It's not 13 Reasons Why. I tried that, and it's... Even though some people were saying that 13 Reasons Why was about like rape or something, I don't know. But I don't know. I tried the first episode, I couldn't get through it, and I'm like... But Riverdale is more interesting because like the first episode itself, we find out that someone actually died. Like there was a soul sequence and everything. You know, it's based on the Archie comics. You know, if you ever read the Archie comics, you know, there's Jughead, Jones.
Okay, then later you show me who's Archie, who's Betty,
right,
who's Veronica.
Archie, Betty. But they also add in some new stuff, you know. As I said about any adaptation, you can add in, you can take away. I don't really care as long as you make it good, you know. And my sister actually told me that the Blossoms were a part of Archie comics, but I don't remember reading that. That might just be a spin-off, but I do remember Josie and the Pussycats, because
that's
one of the staples of
Archie.
Exactly. And of course Pops.
Okay.
The shop that they eat, so that'll be something consistent in the episodes, I think. So yeah, without further ado, let's go. So yeah, this was the past episodes.
So
that's Betty.
Betty, oh
Betty
man.
Cooper. That's Veronica.
Wow.
That's some random guy. I forgot his name.
Why did you?
Did you just
this is FP. That's a random guy. That's the Blossoms. This is Archie. That's Archie.
Okay.
That's Jughead Jones. Cole Sprouse, who played Cody. Do you remember Zack and Cody? The Sweet Life of Zack and Cody.
Okay.
That was Valerie. This is Mrs. Lodge. That's still Veronica. Yeah, she tore her necklace. Cause big thing there was the father is in jail. Like he ended up in jail because he did like I'm thinking embezzling, but I'm not sure because they kept it in the dark. Kind of like we know he did something wrong,
but we don't know what.
Like
it,
we don't know what it is though. That's Archie. Yeah, this is the normal teen life, I guess. Never had parties though. That's the cheerleaders. That's Cheryl Blossom. Her brother died.
Oh.
So the first few episodes, they thought she did it.
She killed her brother.
Yeah, but we're not really sure as well, because she might have, and she, you know, she might have covered. But you know, I don't think so, because there's some sort of sexual tension as well, like. We kind of think that she kind of had like some kind of like more affectionate than you should be with your brother and sister. It was hinted at, but you know, we were never
not
really
sure,
sure, because like a lot of people were saying as well, and I felt it as well, that the replacement was Archie, because you know, he's a jock as well, he's in the football team. The more interesting thing I think should be brought up is Reggie. Because he looks Asian, and a lot of people say he's Asian, but I'm not really sure. Because
okay.
He looks a bit mixed. Don't get me wrong. It's just that he's mixed. That's the father.
Do you want to
Andrews? Questions? I don't think there's captions in this episode.
Okay.
Not sure.
So go.
Usually there will be, but this time, yeah.
It's fine.
I don't know why.
Yeah.
I guess they forgot. Like sometimes, they'll add it in later.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is the new episode.
Maybe.
Okay.
Oh, where is he going? I think he's leaving. Cause in the last episode, him and Mrs. Lodge actually had a thing together, but it wasn't really explored. Yeah, they're both married as well. So that's the kind of the type of thing. And you know, she had to tell Mr. Andrews, which is Archie's father,
okay,
that there's some people after him, because you know, she has some history with like the serpents, which is like a gang, like a motorbike,
okay, motorbike gang.
So yeah, they're after him and everything. And of course, the Blossoms are a big part of that as well. Cause
this is a Blossom, right?
Blossom. No, that's Cooper. That's Betty Cooper. That's Veronica Lodge.
Oh, that's Betty. Blossom,
yeah.
That's Betty.
That's Betty.
She looked different in the last scene that you showed me.
No, that was Cheryl with the really thick red lipstick.
Oh, okay.
That was Cheryl. But this one is Betty. I have to say they really tried to capture Betty, but Veronica, I never really remember her looking like this, but it's an adaptation, I hate it. You know.
Fine.
But Archie, they really got it done, I don't know why, but I'm like, yeah, every time I see that guy, that's Archie, because, you know, the red hair and everything. But the thing about Archie was he had freckles, but, you know, that's really hard for actors to get.
To develop freckles?
I mean, there will be some people with freckles, but...
Yeah, it's not everyone.
And it's very rare nowadays to see people with freckles, I think.
No, maybe in Malaysia, you don't. It's fine. Malaysia, you don't see much. Because that one, sometimes the monitor
sleeps.
The monitors fell down before.
Oh, okay.
Because of my cat. Split in two.
Okay,
and
shit.
It's still okay. You see? Voila. Okay. Sorry. Okay, because we're working on a dual two monitor setup.
Yeah.
Do you watch that?
Zombie.
iZombie.
What is that?
It's kind of a DC team also, right?
I don't know.
If I'm not mistaken, like, it's a part of the DC universe also. I don't know. I've never watched it. Yeah.
I don't watch TV.
So they're trying to think, like, they're trying to find out as well who burned Jason's car, which is Jason. Jason is the brother of Cheryl with the really thick lipstick. So I'm thinking.
That's Jackie. That's what's his name.
Which one?
The guy next to Archie.
The guy next to Archie. Not sure, because they cut it out. Oh, this is Kevin. And this random guy.
He's the
gay friend of the both girls. So usually he will hang out with them. And he has a thing with the random guy with the jacket I told you about in FP's room.
Okay.
That time. But he's also bad a bit, so and her sister is pregnant. Polly Cooper is pregnant with Jason's child, and the big thing is the whole Romeo and Juliet thing, because the Blossoms and the Coopers are, like, you know, clashing families.
Okay.
So once, you know, they had when she was pregnant with the baby, her family was not that supportive of her, but the Blossoms, you know, I think they're more supportive. Because it's another heir, you know, another possible heir. You know, we don't really know the gender of the child, and that was a throwback to the fist meme. By the way,
okay, all right.
It's like when you work out so hard, you know. So now the sister is living with Blossoms, like in their house.
Okay.
And it was revealed in the last episode, which I actually uploaded, but was
Whoa.
Claimed. Yeah, look at that. was claimed, copyright claim. So it's really frustrating.
So
yeah, it's really frustrating.
For girls, it's definitely possible. Like, look at the nails. For girls, guys,
you know, we cut our nails.
Yeah, we cut our nails.
I still like the text, and a lot of people are saying that's a throwback to Stranger Things as well. I kind of agree, because, you know, Stranger Things is the red neon sign.
Hey, but man, all those signs now are coming back, making a comeback.
Right. FP is a drinker, you know? He's an alcoholic a little bit, and he had a falling out with Mr. Andrews. Because of, you know, his he's in the serpent gang,
okay.
The one I told you about when, you know, they were coming after the Mr. Andrews and stuff. Betty is in the no sorry not Betty Polly is in the Blossoms docile home.
Okay.
Basically, we found out that she was just there to find out like what they had to do with Jason's death. So that was like the big reveal in the last episode. And we also saw that Cheryl has more issues than we thought, because like she really tried to like manipulate Archie into being like in a relationship with her and everything, but he didn't take that. So she was like, I thought you were different, like different from other people, because like you know, you're the good guy, that, you know, the Boy Scout that won't really use me for my status, but you're just like the other guys. But when he broke up with her, she got really angry, and I kind of questioned that. I'm like, wait, if you want someone different, like if they break up with you, that should be it, right? Yeah. Like, but you know, she got all angry, and then you know, she asked, there was a photo of them together, like they went to like some maple syrup tradition thing,
mm-hmm.
and then so they took a picture, and then black and white. So she was in a room, and then she was crossing out Archie's face, you know, and then Polly came in, you know, just to say goodnight, and then she was like, yeah, goodnight, but then she crossed out Polly's face too, so that was like the one, yeah, that was the one that was like supposed to be.
How many episodes in?
This is the 9th episode, the 10th episode.
Season 1.
Okay,
still can't catch up. So then by next week, I'll be all covered. God damn, there's a lot of things I need to catch up, man.
Well, you know, you could skip Flash.
I'm not watching
Flash. Yeah, just
I don't know, watch Flash is okay, I can watch it every time, but Flash is not that hard for me to catch up. Call me geek.
And a lot of people are speculating that Flash is Sevatar. That's Iris Cat.
Flash is Sevatar?
They're speculating, but we're not sure. But we're not sure.
You spoiled it for me.
We're not sure.
I really Sevatar as the guy who's like, I'm the god of speed, you know?
Yeah,
that's it.
Still
the and now you're telling me that. What the
it
hell?
Could be, we're not sure. Okay. I haven't seen the theories. That's Cheryl with the. Yeah, this is Cheryl.
So they're both the one that stepped on the black guy just now in the pool, right?
No, that was Veronica and Betty. But Betty was wearing the wig.
The wig, yes, I noticed that.
Yeah. But because like she found out that the black guy, the guy with the necklace, hoodie, he had the book. You know, you saw the book, right? That was like the playbook, or you know, Barney would say it's a playbook, but really it's more more sleazy in a way, because like it's
okay.
I had to watch this part
for
a
while. I think she's hot.
Yeah, she's hot.
But I think
she's pretty hot.
Yeah, she's definitely hot, but I don't know why she doesn't feel Veronica-ish.
Yeah, that's the thing. And that's the thing, because like I've always envisioned Veronica as more of Cheryl, because Cheryl is the one like is the kind of the rich kid but doesn't really
this,
care.
You imagine this as Veronica?
Yeah, like some way in like.
Yes, I would say she actually looks better as Veronica. This girl, yes, but Cheryl.
But in terms of the comic, I get it, like, cause you know Veronica was a brunette.
Yeah, all they have to do is just color her hair black. And she would have actually, I think she, you imagine her black in black hair, she would actually, she would pull off the Veronica look very well.
Mm.
No offense to you, you're hot.
Okay. She's still hot, bro. And Betty's not bad, like Betty's the...
Come on, Betty, do your thing too.
Betty's the good girl kind of thing,
yeah.
You know?
Supergirl.
I don't think I'm going to continue Supergirl, to be honest. Like, that's one of the things I'm thinking about, because Supergirl is getting really repetitive. I'm sorry, it's a CW property too, so I get to talk about it because it's all under the CW.
Yeah, she looks a lot better as Veronica. See, the red lipstick,
right? And the like kind of
the
like,
hairstyle also a bit better, closer.
Kind of like that arrogancy, but also she's also down, like you know, she's down to
earth. He's an adaptation. Forgive them all.
Nah, I don't really care.
It's funny bit. Yeah, you Marvel, you can't accept, huh?
Hey, you know, sometimes short form media, like short form films, I'm good. Like, and it depends, because usually, you know, in a longer format, you really want them to look a certain way, feel a certain way. And I think that's why I was kind of displeased with Batman v Superman, is because of the aesthetic feel of it. You know, it was too dark. It was too like...
He tried too hard.
Yeah, he tried too hard. He tried too hard with the gritty. And I'm like, dude, you don't need this. I already know that you're a really good cinematographer from Watchmen. And this is Pops, by the way. She just came into Pops. I love Pops because they got Pops down really good. This is the classic American feel
diner.
Yeah, American feel diner. You can see the monk trick in the background right there.
I like the neon milkshake at the back.
Right. That, yeah. And then, see? They did the milkshake really good.
How would you know if it's good?
No, that's what I imagined whenever I read the comics.
Okay.
Like, that's something I always wanted to see in real life, but never got to see in real life.
Something going on?
So basically, Veronica is trying to rid her father's sins and really try to get things back on track.
Yeah. But the way it's a method she does it, right? It always seems a bit off, right?
I mean, technically she doesn't, like, she isn't supposed to be in the... I mean, you know, company law states that, you know, the owner should have a stated heir, and if it's not stated, then somebody has to vote them in. But she was never voted in, so I'm not sure if they're gonna go like really realistic with it or not. But, like, yeah, that's something we'll have to
see. You know how it is. If you're not voted in, don't you still get a share percentage of, because your father was the owner of the company, right?
Technically,
right. You should still get like royalty, right, or something like that.
Because you own the name Lodge, so
it's my name.
Yeah, but again, you know, maybe it's my Asian mentality, but it's usually for guys. I'm not sure about girls. But. And there's the thing I was talking about, the Blossoms as well. Like, they need an heir. That's why...
It's Jughead, right?
That's Jughead, yeah. Yeah, you can tell by the beanie. Like, I don't really know how I feel about the beanie. I know he has to have it because, you know, usually in the comics,
he needs it. But
I don't know how to feel about that, because, like,
I don't know how he's here. Okay, I don't know.
So that's Betty. They're dating, by the way.
Oh, it's there. Archie hasn't started dating Betty yet, lah.
Yeah.
Okay. And Veronica is still trying for Archie.
Well,
is Veronica trying for Archie now? That's basically how it is in the comics, right? You know, right?
I don't really want to spoil anything.
I'll catch up.
But you need to know that the first episode, they already clarified some stuff there, so...
Okay.
Yeah. That's Ethel. Like, that's... that is... another character that's connected to the Lodges in some way, because her family kind of invested in the lodge industry, and then, you know, because of the whole thing, he went to jail, you know, they lost money as well. So in the last episode, Veronica had to tell Ethel that she's a lodge. So, you know, there was some drama there, but it kind of got resolved really quickly, which I was pretty surprised. But I'm like, yeah, okay, I don't think you needed to drag that out as well. Because
you're bringing another story for nothing, yeah.
And also, Ethel is part of the whole vindictive playbook thing, because the black guy also, like, marked her. I say vindictive because, like, it's the ratings. Like, they usually, like, tell, like, if the chick is, like, bangable, like, how good is she in bed, that kind of stuff, so. And sometimes they'll have like dream sequences, like not really dream sequences, like in Batman v Superman, but there was a dream sequence with Javed. He dreamed about the perfect American family, and that was where we saw the real designs. If it was from the proper comics, like him having the crown
and everything,
you know, Betty really being the really blonde.
That was a dreamer.
That was a dreamer.
Nice.
So, and then Archie was with the classic, like the
red shirt. Oh, the classic shirt.
Yeah.
Sweatshirt with the collar.
Mm-hmm. Oh. Oh shit. Shit just got real. Cause Mr. Andrews was technically separated from Mrs. Andrews, but we never know why. They're just the type, I guess. Now they're getting the divorce, so that's something that plays into it as well. That's something that plays into Archie's psyche as well, because in this one he's more of the he's on the keeper. He's more of the, you know, the music guy, and he's really into his music. And I guess that's the thing with the comics as well. He was kind of musicish. Yeah, inclined.
Yes, it comes. Yeah. The cat unbuckles.
The cat.
Yeah.
Is.
This is
life with cats.
This is my cat. Yeah.
This is life with cats, right?
I'm a busybody.
The cat always wants to be famous. Oh shit! No. I knew it. I was like, wait, something's going down.
So they just want a normal party, like standard party, but this one just want like...
We wanna wreck your place.
Yes.
yeah.
We're going to tear this place upside down.
Woohoo!
Goodbye. This is not my kind of birthday party, right? I wanna...
The guy just want like, have a...
Yeah, just like
night,
a chill party, yeah.
Not like horror party like this.
Oh, okay, so that's where the
okay
party for the first part came into. Oh, this is the guy I was talking about, actually. The guy with the teeth on his necklace.
And the guy who is supposed to be having his birthday.
Yeah.
He just chilling.
He's just like chilling inside.
Like, he doesn't want any of it.
This sucks.
You also bought that thing, huh? The same thing with Flint.
Yeah. I got Flint's one inside there. This is mine. For someone like me who wrestles, I need this one.
Yeah, he Jughead and his father has some strained relationships, because like they're not really close because he's an alcoholic. So
it's like, I care for you, but.
Yeah, it's like...
Stop trying to be in my life, something like that, right?
Something like that, yeah.
If you want to be in my life, be in my life. If you don't want to be in my life, don't be in my life, I guess. Yeah, that's how it is.
Okay.
This is America.
Yeah, and, you know, with same-sex marriage being legalized, it's more open.
Even in movies, everything was trying to always put gay guys.
Yeah, and to the point now, it's also about like tokenism, like how are you gonna put them in if people are immediately gonna think that they're tokens already? So
yeah.
That cake looks good though. I'm just saying.
That's
I might be hungry though.
That's a sad cake, right?
I might just be hungry though.
What was this flashback about?
She's a MP with her mom passing money. It's definitely money, because who passes drugs anymore? She saw him with her, so you know she thought there was something there, but it's just business. Basically, she's paying off the gang.
Okay.
Not to come and disturb. Yeah.
Protection money, like something like that.
Something
like
that. She hates this guy, by the way, because it's like there was something written in the book, I don't really remember what it said, but like Jason like wrote something about her sister that she felt was like super like disgusting.
Rude,
yeah.
Rude, disgusting. This was a revenge thing about her.
That was the revenge in the flashback. Oh. You deserve that, bro. To be honest with you, he really deserved that.
Where went the sister?
She's pregnant, so she's living with the Blossom
The
Blossom estate.
But I don't know who's the
and,
father. Who's
the father is Jason.
Jason.
Yeah, Jason Blossom.
Which died.
Which died. And the thing about it is like in the past episodes they were talking about it and they left it a while, like they left that storyline a while, but now they're capitalizing it again, so hopefully they explore it more. Because this one of the things that I think is like kind of distracting about this series is that you also have to get characters to interact with each other, and then you have a mystery as well, so you always have to divide
read
that. Yeah, you have to divide that and let the characters interact naturally and then move into the mystery again, but at some points it feels like they're forgetting about the mystery, they're forgetting about the death of Jason,
they can run off
so
too
yeah
far. That's a Sherlock, so good, right?
Yeah.
One episode is so good, right?
So, these kinds of episodes, I call them filler episodes, because it's just to push the characters in and have some drama, you know. And sometimes, you know, I feel the actors are a bit overacting sometimes. Some points, you know, you'll see that too, I think. And the Polly before she came back to Riverdale, she was in some, like, it was some kind of, like, monastery, kind of. It was not a monastery, but it was, like, some, like, church place.
Okay.
That, yeah.
Getting upset.
Yeah.
I just want a normal birthday party to invite everybody. Archie comes and steals.
That's Valerie. He really likes her, by the way. And she's part of the Josie and the Pussycat fans. Yeah. Of course she got jealous because, you know, he was spending too much time with Cheryl. But here's the twist. He did tell her that, you know, he was going to just accommodate Cheryl, not really like do anything, but just accommodate her, because, you know, he needs a chance, and, you know, if you have an opportunity,
the breakdown,
yeah, his whole world just crashed right there, dead. And, but, you know, he was spending too much time with her and everything, so she felt she was being left out.
Being
left
out,
like,
it's normal.
She was like, you know, what...
So you say, I have to take care of my girlfriend.
And then she was like, you know, how long until you forget about me, like, something like that, and then, you know.
Girls.
That's why I don't bother. That's why I don't bother. Yeah, just like
how to navigate. Can you navigate through that delicate maze? You know.
That's why I don't bother. I'm just like, nah, it's good.
Nah, eventually you'll find the right girl. I just won't take it so long. This girl's a dick. See, she's so rude. She's so good as Veronica, actually. Because Veronica is actually the one that's supposed to be the snobby.
Oh, nope. She locked the door.
Get me out of here! What's going on now?
She probably wants the party to continue, but Oh. Yeah, she moved a lot. Oh, that was a big move. She brought up the dad,
yeah,
who's in jail.
This is basically just trying to embarrass the people. Veronica, Betty. Jughead is just
collateral. I guess it's because she showed her off in the gym.
Yeah,
she's not showing you.
I don't know, man.
Cat
fights.
The cat comes again. This was a big plot in that as well, like, cause Archie, they kind of screwed his teacher. Yep, and he was there on the day Jason died, so
she said she has a suspect. Can we consider a suspect?
He's supposed to be a suspect, yeah.
Man, American student politics, man. Check it out.
Yeah, that's true.
Judge, jury, executioner.
I mean, you know, in Malaysia, I think we were lucky not to have these type of cliques. But except I think there was some.
I'm just, you know, there is some schools that do have these kind of cliques. Yeah. Not all schools. My school probably might have this kind of cliques. Can be considered not as bitchy as this kind of thing. Like, I don't know.
Nah, my school was more of the dicks that came up to you and said, "Hey, ngapuni."
Yeah, exactly.
You need to pray.
Yeah, it's okay. I didn't text anyone from.
I knew it. I was like, ah, oh, man, Jughead's gonna do something, cause like he was getting more and more angry.
My son right there, man.
Yeah, that was the look.
Don't,
man,
you put your look. Hands on my
that,
son.
That was the look, man. Party's over, yeah. I knew he was gonna say that. Go home. Whoa. Chill out, bro. Oh, and I guess that's the more interesting thing, is that we see the comic book characters in a more adult light.
A more realistic
way. Yeah, in a more teenage way.
And Jackie just likes burgers, man.
Yeah, that's it. He was kind of the guy who eats a lot.
Yeah.
And he was implied to be like that stoner guy.
Yeah.
Backstory to this is that all of the parents went to school with each other as well. So the Blossoms, the Coopers, and the the Andrews and the Lodges went to school together, the same school together. So, I mean, look at that. That's a really good recreation of the milkshake.
Yes, right? Yes. Okay, I get the milkshake. But yeah, yeah.
I'm really surprised, man. I just want to see the soda now, because usually in the comics it was usually a float, you know, the soda with the ice cream.
What a promotion.
You should be with McDonald's next time they come up with a new milkshake, bro.
Nah,
I'm only, referring to you.
The only proper place to get like a milkshake now is like, you know, Johnny Rockets in Sunway. That's the really good one. Or
is Johnny Rockets in Curve?
I think. But that's really expensive because that's the really authentic, American diner.
We're all broken, aren't we? Right, I keep wrecking things. We're all broken, aren't we?
Sometimes they drag it out. The story.
I mean, it's about romance.
Yeah.
It is. I guess being in chemistry. If you...
Veronica has just. By the way, Veronica is pining for Archie.
Yeah, she always does.
But
Reggie?
There's Reggie, but we hardly see him though. Strange,
yeah,
because in the comics he's supposed to be the
main bad guy in a way, yeah.
He's supposed to be the counter to Archie
exactly.
But I guess they wanted to have a female Gordon instead, so it's more of the counter to Veronica and maybe. Betty, yeah. But not to say there wasn't, because there was a few scenes in the earlier episodes with Reggie. By the way, they already clarified if you remember the comics, they Veronica and Betty made a pact to have a line between being friends with Archie and flirting with Archie. You don't remember that? That was in the comics.
I don't really read it. I pick up clips of it, you know. So. Yeah, where's the line?
They said like, okay, we won't go after Archie, like, cause they just got sick of fighting over Archie one day, and they were like, okay, we'll just be friends and not go after
Archie. And Archie ends up alone.
Archie is usually he's blissfully, you know, in his own world, so he doesn't.
He will choose whoever he wants.
Yeah, but there was actually one point that he ended up with Veronica for a while, and then. And then they moved to Betty.
Come on, man.
Too much work.
Too much work.
I'm really a lazy guy, guys. Like, I'm really.
Like I said, bro, you just need to find the right lazy girl.
Yeah.
Or the girl who wants to come here.
And Jughead found out. He knows.
Yeah, I knew you were what you wanted. You got what you want today?
Sips tea.
That's so poor Cheryl.
Fucker. It's strange that they still have a butler, by the way. This is their butler. You know, like, with all the talk of, like, going...
Yeah, bankrupt,
like,
and everything.
No, I don't even know if they're going bankrupt by this point.
Yeah, like, being taken over.
Yeah.
So they still have money, lah, I'm assuming.
Yeah, I guess so.
Just that you might not have power on the
country. Yeah, I was saying, too, in the last episode, which I was supposed to upload, but I couldn't. Again, copyright.
Okay.
they had, like, crystals. Like, crystal glass, you know. They were drinking tea out of them, like, how broke are you?
You're not broke. It's relative to you guys. It's relative to the person, right?
It's first world broke, you know?
I don't think these people know how to live, like, without a butler. So simple as that, lah. That's why for them, broke is broke. You know?
Broke is, like, not being able to buy another car. That's all it is.
Yes, you know? Not being able to spoil yourself with drinks and stuff, you know?
I mean, this is being broke, like, drinking out of the milk carton, even though I've never done that before because my mom would smack me upside the head if I did that.
Awesome, bro. Hello? Go kat mana? Lagi sayang? Ambil aku? Boleh? Thank you. Ciao. Okay, I got a friend to go pray with. Because I don't have my wallet. I don't drive the car.
Do you need to buy stuff?
What, you want to belanja?
No. She has to ask you.
This is people are right.
By the way, the mother kind of like told the father off, because the father is the really the egotistical one. You know, because he was like, no, we will not have Paul in the house because, like, she's carrying Blossom Strong, blah blah blah. And then she was like, you know what, hang you, and thanks. Yeah. It's over. And she threw a brick in the window. That was really cool. And that was just the recent episode, the last episode. So. Well, fuck. I thought she was gonna testify against him because they made a whole big deal about it in the last episode, so... Because especially, you know, when you saw her pull up the necklace, she said that was the necklace her father gave her to kind of like give her trinkets to keep her quiet.
Quiet, yeah. Spoil you, right?
Spoil her. Mm-hmm. How? Well, you know.
Are you guys hungry or something?
I'm actually very hungry now.
You?
That's after this.
After no, just yeah. just you know, so after I pray, I go back makan. Do you go makan?
Ah, okay.
Does your do your viewers know that you're Malaysian?
Some of them know.
Okay.
Yeah. Cause usually, I would tell them like in Malaysia we don't really have these things.
Yeah? She didn't testify again at that. Keep it quiet. Did it say thank you?
Because it said thank you, daddy, so I'm not sure whether it's to her dad or, you know.
Oh, she's the one sending it to him.
I'm not sure.
She's the mother?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, okay, this is the first time we saw her.
Whoa.
Is that the end? Okay, that is the end.
I would probably actually catch up, like, because I do like Archie comics. I read Archie comics when I was a kid. I would actually just go through this series. I mean, catch up to where you are to see if I actually enjoy it. Because at the moment, I can't really say.
Right.
No, because there's too many things going on, right?
Yeah, so many things going on.
There's too many things going on.
Guys, I know, like, you know, it seemed like we were really watching the episode, but I say this every time, like, even though I'm not focusing on the episode, really, I'm still picking up stuff, like, because my brain multitasks, you know?
Smart.
So, okay, so we've seen Archie's mom now, so my prediction is that she's going to come in to the next episode. We're not really going to see the father, as he picked up his bag and, you know, it looked like he's going to leave town. There was more stuff about Veronica, more stuff about Buddy, not much about Polly. Sorry, you didn't get to see Polly this episode, but I definitely think she'll be in the next episode.
She has to be in the finale,
I mean, you know, because she's still kind of mourning over Jason's death.
How long has it been in terms of the duration of the movie?
In terms of the series, it's been like 6 months that he's dead. And when Betty told Polly that Jason died, she didn't know. So that was something interesting.
That's why she's mourning down.
So yeah, that's about it, guys. And I will see you in the next episode.
See you guys.